In this packet, we will look at exponential functions. First, we start by graphing the exponential function y equals 2 to the x. Now that we have a table of values, we can plot the points and see what the graph looks like. Another similar example. Notice the previous examples were very similar in that positive values of x yielded y values that increased very rapidly. And for negative x values, we ended up with fractions that get smaller as x increases. This is the general shape for exponential functions. So this example should follow the previous descriptions. Let's see. Yep. Notice this example looks very similar to y equals 2 to the x, except all the y values are moved down by 4. Remember this pattern when we graphed quadratic functions? Now let's look at solving exponential equations. Notice if we can manipulate both sides of the equation to have the same base, the exponents must be equal. Next example. We can manipulate 81 to have the same base, 3, as the left side of the equation. So x equals 4. Next example. Another example. In general, if you have an equation with variable exponents, if you can get both sides with the same base, then you can solve by setting the exponents equal to each other. Try these. An application example. Now we will introduce a new notation, logarithmic notation. Ultimately, you want to be able to go from logarithmic notation and exponent notation. Some examples. Reading this correctly as log base 2 of 32 is equal to can be written in exponent notation as base 2 to the power of what equals 32. And in exponent notation, it is simple to figure out the exponent is 5. In general, reading each example correctly will help you remember what logarithms are, exponents. This example is read as log base 5 of 125 equals the exponent. Again, writing an exponent notation can help figure what exponent that is. Next example. Next example. Now, let's look at a couple of graphs of logarithms. Notice that when graphing logarithms by hand, it may be helpful to rewrite in exponent notation.